About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And since it's February, this evening our program is going to be about health. So my guests are Pamela Kneass, and she is from Natural Pet Path. Natural Path Pet. Natural Path. Okay, got that. Natural Path Pet in Hamburg. And with her are Kim and Danny and their little girl, Sadie, who, of course, is very comfortable here. So, first of all, I think we'll talk to Pam and ask her how she sort of got involved in natural remedies and products for dogs.
Cats, I guess, also.
Also, I do both, cats and dogs.
Okay.
First, I always like to clarify that I'm not a veterinarian.
Okay.
I do not treat or diagnose disease.
Okay.
My job is to support the body in its own natural healing mm-hmm. mechanisms mm-hmm. Through natural support, nutritional supplements, things like that.
Okay.
It's a holistic approach, so I take into mind the whole dog, not just the physical, but also their emotional and their mental status as well. But I got into it, I've been a veterinary technician for almost 25 years now.
Okay.
So I've been in the field of veterinary medicine for a long time. And as natural remedies started becoming more of a thing for humans, they started looking for a resource for their animals. And unfortunately, being that a lot of supplements aren't FDA regulated, the veterinarians aren't in a position that they can freely speak about supplements. It doesn't mean your vet's against them.
That's right.
They just don't have the opportunity or the mm-hmm. freedom to really speak about them.
Right, right.
So and the internet has so much information and so much information that's conflicting and confusing. And
wrong, just outright wrong.
Exactly. That, you know, I felt like there really needed to be a resource, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. for something, somewhere for people to go to get more information
right,
when
right,
they're looking
right.
to take that natural step.
Right.
And many years ago, it actually started with Kim's mom. Mm-hmm. She had a basset hound by the name of Charlie.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
And
okay.
he had liver cancer. And they, you know, just said, hey, he's got a short amount of time. Enjoy
yes.
him while you have him.
Mm-hmm.
And mom asked me to look into mm-hmm. some stuff, some remedies.
Yep.
So I started doing my research, coming across a bunch of different stuff. We had him on a regimen that I can't even remember now.
I don't
exactly
know.
What
yeah.
it was.
Yeah. Yeah.
But he was with us for
2.5 years
wow.
after he was diagnosed.
And yeah. that really got me set up in the direction that I needed to go.
Yes.
And so I started doing the research, and I found a program online from
right.
Kingdom College of Natural Health that offers a doctorate in the
okay.
naturopathic animal
okay.
science.
Okay, very
so
good.
So I made sure I got myself educated in that.
Yes.
And so now
yes.
I have a really nice understanding from being in the vet field for so long and now knowing the natural end of it. I know the disease process. I know the treatments. I know the prescription
mm-hmm.
meds. I know what side effects they may have.
And the side effects are a big one.
And, you know, mm-hmm. and things that we can do to support that and help
mm-hmm.
prevent those side effects, you know, or minimize those side effects.
Right, right.
I always say I'm a minimalist, not a purist.
Yes.
I will never tell you to stop giving the medication your vet has prescribed. That's a conversation for you and your vet.
Yes, yes.
However, I am there to support the dog and the dog's body and give them the best chance
right.
of survival with whatever they're dealing with or just to improve their overall
yes.
quality of
yes.
life.
And you work with a vet that does believe in it and recommends it.
Again, he's supportive.
Right.
Yep.
That's exactly right. And it's very hard to find a vet that actually, I'm lucky, my vets do as well. But it's sometimes really difficult to tell a vet, well, I'm going to use this as well. Well, what do you mean? I'm giving you the medication that you need. And some are just a little bit worried, you know, you got to give just what I say and nothing else, even though, you know, I myself am taking something else, you know.
Yeah.
I supplement my diet as well. So why shouldn't I help my dogs with a problem if I can?
And right. what's nice is, I mean, prescription medications work right away. You know, they're
yes.
pretty darn quick.
That's exactly right.
The natural stuff takes longer to build up in their system.
Mm-hmm.
And if we want an animal to feel better, we need to make sure that they feel better. So getting them on the prescription meds initially to get through whatever they're going through and then add in the natural support so we can either use those prescription meds maybe less frequently
yes.
or the vet can prescribe a lower dose,
mm-hmm.
You know, or maybe be prevented altogether.
Yes.
But it's not one or the other. There really needs to be a blend of both,
right.
I think, for it to be
yes. I agree.
You know, really
I
beneficial
agree.
For the pet and
mm-hmm.
for the pet owner.
Because, you know, I also believe in the homeopathy and, you know, the Bach essences, and I use them all for different purposes. And no, I'm not a practitioner. No, I didn't study. Yes, I went to some classes, but I'm not an expert, but I figure if it's helping me, it's going to help the dogs, you know?
Right. Most definitely.
Right.
Right. So, right. You know, and it's like I said, difficult to actually find a lot of vets who are willing to say, yeah, go right ahead and do what you think you need to do.
Right.
But yes, I guess Dr. Casa is probably, I don't know if you know, if you're aware Dr. Casa. Okay. She is a homeopathic vet, and I think she's down in Audubon.
Homeopathy is an entire course
that's exactly right.
To itself, you know.
Right.
I work with a handful of prepared
homeopathic.
Thank
yes.
you. Oh my.
That's the word. Yes.
That's
yes.
the word. But I don't specialize in that
right.
because it
right.
is such a broad area
yes.
of
that's
study
that's
that
exactly
I think that
right.
needs to
that's
be done.
Exactly
so
right.
you know, and, leave that to the experts.
Yeah, and with the dogs, you know, they can't tell you, man, I really feel horrible. You know, I'm really sick in the stomach, unless they're vomiting to let you know that this medication yeah. is making them feel even worse.
And being that so much of the homeopathics are also individual personality related, you know,
yes,
is
it is.
That mm-hmm. it's hard, for, again, to get that information from a dog. So,
yes.
yeah, that's a whole specialty all yeah. by itself.
Yes. yep. yes, that's exactly right. But so how about you tell us a little bit about some of the products that you do have?
Sure.
And actually, what do you treat? Is there, I mean, if a dog has anxiety. You have a remedy for anxiety?
So again, and I have to be specific that I do not treat anything.
Okay.
I support the body of the dog.
That's
just an important clarification.
Yes, yes.
However, yeah, I deal with a lot of different animals with a lot of different issues.
Okay.
From anxiety to, of course, allergy-related aspect of things. I
okay.
mean, that's such an issue anymore these
yes,
days.
Yes, it certainly is.
I've supported numerous dogs with different forms of cancer, from lymphoma to osteosarcoma
mm-hmm,
to
mm-hmm.
liver cancer to just recently mammary cancer. So mm-hmm. there's, and again, all these things pre-diagnosed at their vet, you
mm-hmm,
know,
mm-hmm.
and Cushing's disease. So it all depends on the dog. And when it comes to remedies, I don't have anything one specific for that I use across the board. It's really tailored to each individual dog, again, because from a holistic standpoint, we're taking into consideration the whole dog.
Right.
You
right.
know, so if you have a dog that might be allergic, but then they also are older, and so they have an arthritis aspect of things, you know, and they're starting to get sore, or
mm-hmm.
they maybe they starting with a little cognitive type issues.
Right.
Something like colostrum is an amazing supplement. Because it helps support all of those functions.
Right, right.
You know, it's great for the immune system.
Yeah.
So you can find like one supplement that maybe does multiple things. So each one is tailored to each individual dog and
okay.
what their need is.
Yeah.
I do consultations for the dogs at the Animal Resource Cooperation
okay.
located in Hamburg
okay.
on South
right,
3rd
right,
Street.
Right.
And so that's where I offer a lot of the services. I also do a lot of behavior work there with these kids, and we have an
oh.
enrichment room there.
Uh-huh.
But that's getting into a whole different subject.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Well, we're treating the whole dog.
Right, exactly.
exactly.
You know, and so that room provides a stress relief for the dogs, the
mm-hmm.
indoor playroom in the enrichment
mm-hmm.
area. It provides mental stimulation and, again, stress relief. These guys are like sponges. We don't realize how much of our own stress is
oh,
fed into
yes.
these guys, and how much of our stress is carried around in their body
mm-hmm.
and in their
mm-hmm.
cells that they also need to be able to release and detox
right.
and all those
right.
things.
Right.
You know, and, again, providing that natural support, giving them that little boost to help their body do that on their own. I
yeah.
love it.
Yeah, that's...
Yeah.
And you can see the results.
Most
oh,
definitely.
Absolutely.
You can see the
most
results.
Definitely.
So let's see what we have here.
So
you have some of the products.
Some of the products I have here are some of them that I use on a fairly regular basis
oh, okay.
or that I
okay.
would be speaking about when we speak about Sadie.
Okay. Okay.
But we were talking about the homeopathics.
Uh-huh.
And one of the main preparations I use is this group here from Tea Relief, put out by
okay.
Medimatura. They have a tea relief pain, a tea relief arthritis, and a tea relief calming. And it's actually a blend of herbal varieties of homeopathics.
Oh.
So for the calming, it's like a chamomile valerian root blend.
Okay, okay.
It's not enough to cause any form of sedation. It's
mm-hmm.
not, it works on a vibrational level, so it's not a drug, so it doesn't interfere with any of the drugs that the animals
mm-hmm,
are on.
Mm-hmm.
It's enough to kind of calm them down just a bit that they are able to then think through the
right,
process
right.
rather than just react
yes,
or stress themselves
yes,
out.
Take the edge off.
So it takes the edge
yes,
off, brings
yes.
them down just a little bit. I know you and I were speaking. You
mm-hmm.
have a high anxiety dog.
Yes, I do.
and so there's a bunch of different things, and it all depends on the level of anxiety you're dealing with, whether
mm-hmm.
you can try something like this or whether or not you need to see the vet for a prescription product,
right,
you know, to
right,
help that
right.
kid. And then they have their tea relief pain, which is has like an anti-inflammatory type effect.
Okay.
It's really nice. It helps delay putting some of these sore kids on the prescription. arthritic medications.
Okay.
So if we can push that off a couple extra years, since we know that long-term use has some side effects.
Yes.
So if you can push that off until they're 10 or 11, and we're worried about long-term use 6 years from now, it's a great blend. So it's a nice place to start to help some of these kids when they're sore. And then the arthritis is specifically made to help increase mobility.
Right.
And so they actually, the T-relief pain and the T-relief arthritis is a really nice pairing together.
Yeah.
But most common things that I probably go through at the center is those products there.
Right.
They're very popular. Yeah. They're great for all around use. The T-relief pain is a perfect option to have into your first pet first aid kit.
Yes.
Everybody wants to give aspirin. And then when you go.
And it's not, now this pain relief is not just for arthritis, it's for other pain as well.
Correct. It can be, again, anytime there's a source of discomfort.
Okay. You know, they hurt their leg.
Correct.
That kind. Okay.
And it's just a nice, gentle, you know, again, non-prescription product. It's safe to use. A lot of people, when their dog injures themselves on the weekend, they read online, they give them aspirin, they go to the vet on Monday, then the vet's restricted about what they can use.
Mm-hmm.
And all the medication they would have used to make your dog feel better, they can't use now because, and they even sell, everybody says, well, it's safe because I bought the dog-related aspirin at the store.
Right, yes.
And it's still, they have to do a washout before your vet can start any prescription drugs. So this is nice, again, because it works on a vibrational level, so it doesn't affect the chemistry of the dog.
Right.
Know? But I have great luck. Yeah. I had a pit bull for 16 years, cream puff, and he was hit by a car and was found up on Route 81, and he had two broken back legs.
Oh, my word.
He had surgery on the one leg, and the other leg repaired naturally. It formed a fusion of the bone, and it stabilized that joint on its own, so they left that. And I assumed there was no way he was going to make it past 8.
Right.
And again, he was 16. I was so lucky to have him that long, and he still was only on prescription meds as needed. When he had a bad day or when he went outside thinking that he was young and a pup and running
like a
fool, tripping up the stairs or whatever he might have been doing.
Yes.
But, you know, he still wasn't on them on a daily basis.
Wow.
You know, so I'm really...
And you had him on this pain relief and the arthritis then as well.
I did the combo of the two.
Yeah, because now they came out with this new drug, Librela, and now I'm reading so many dogs that have bad effects as well as, you know, yes, it helps, but... People are saying, you know, well, I might use it as a last resort, but, you know, so if you have a dog that's fairly young, like 8, 9 years old, that's just starting.
If we can delay some of those prescription drugs,
right.
You know, and that's just beneficial for the body in general, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And again, those drugs are necessary, you know, in certain cases.
Yes.
But again, if you can delay needing that, and you still have that step to go to. So as your dog continues to age and as things continue to progress, you still have all those weapons in your arsenal, you know, with your vet
that,
to go
that
to.
You can go to if you
Correct.
Need to. Right.
Yep.
Right.
So if we can delay someone starting some of those prescription drugs, then we have those to keep our kids healthier longer and more comfortable longer.
Very good.
Right? You agree?
So
yes.
What is this then?
So that's actually a four-leaf rover. I'm a big fan of their supplements. They are NASC certified. That is the National Animal Supplement Council.
Oh, okay.
Big issue with supplements, of course, is there's no regulation.
Right.
So packaging, and they can almost package whatever they want. So you need to make sure you have a good source.
Mm-hmm.
And if you can find something that is NASC certified, they do all the third-party testing. they have quality of standard they must maintain. They're checked in and inspected multiple times a year. And things
like that
to make sure that you're getting the quality of the product and what it is actually on the label. So if you can find a product with that, it's an added bonus.
That's exactly right. Even with human medications,
correct.
Sometimes it's, you know.
If you can find one of the certifications form.
That's exactly right.
Four Leaf Rover has a complete line of prepared nutraceuticals. And their colostrum is one I go to all the time. The one in your hand is their kibble fixer. That is now their boost for if you're feeding, you know, a regular kibble diet. Again, there's a lot of conversation and a lot of different opinions when it comes to nutrition and what's best, but then there's also reality. And even somebody who wants to sit down and take the time to feed a raw diet and have the expense of a raw diet, other people can't, and they need convenience. The nice thing about that, it's a topper right for the food that gives you all the benefits of a whole food diet to boost the power of your kibble. So it's a really nice additive. It is probiobiotics, digestive enzymes, and antioxidants.
Oh, okay.
And so we all know how important the probiotics are to gut health and how much gut health now is regulating the rest of the health. We're learning so much more about that. And the antioxidants, of course, trapping the free radicals and reducing the stress on the cells, make healthier cells. So it's a really nice product.
How is this fed?
It's just sprinkled right over the food.
Okay.
Yep, once a day.
Like a tablespoon or teaspoon?
Yep. My girl is about 40 pounds, and she gets a half a teaspoon once a day.
Oh, okay, okay.
So that little bag there lasts for 45 days for a large dog. Okay. So it's nice, and it's cost-effective,
yes,
too.
Yes, it certainly is.
Yep.
Yeah, because I noticed it's a 45-day supply, and it's like, wow, that's teeny little bags.
Especially, again, you know, and especially in today's finances, when you're trying to balance doing what's right for your dog, problems that I had in the past when I was looking into different natural things is some of the costs on some of them.
Oh, yes.
So I also think it's important to find things that are cost effective because it's not helpful if the client can't afford to do it for their pet long term.
Right.
You know?
Right. That's exactly right.
So, and then Four Leaf Rover, like I said, we had the colostrum here. And another product of mine that's a big go-to is their Guts and Glory. I'm a big fan of glandulars.
Okay.
Glandulars are freeze-dried organ cells. So basically, they're like a substitute staff. So this is a multi-glandular, so it's heart, liver, spleen, pancreas.
So it takes care of everything.
It takes care of the whole body, because again, we talk about whole body.
Right.
But basically, if the liver is challenged or the kidney is challenged, this is almost like a substitute staff for that organ for the day. So it's just fed orally. It has a great beef taste. Even the cats, I have a cat who goes nuts for it. If I open the container, his nose is in there trying to get it. I've had multiple cats on it for kidney failure because there's not a lot to do to support the kidney once, you know, they're at that point, you know, or even severe kidney disease. Again, diagnosed at their vet, not by me. But the glandulars seem to help maintain that because, again, the cells are going in and doing the work of, and taking the workload off the healthy cells. So they have a chance to kind of regenerate and get healthier again. So glandulars are a really cool product.
Yeah. So then what would you actually be using that for?
So I use that for most of my cancer patients because, again, if they're going through, you know, especially if they're electing to do chemo and things like that, it's important that every organ in the body is provided for in some way.
Yeah.
And the glandulars, like this Guts and Glory, is with it being a multi-glandular, it's just a one-step fashion to do all of that.
Okay.
So, again, kids who have any sort of liver issues, if they have been on carprofen long-term, you know, which is a prescription pain medication, and the vet's starting to notice some of those liver value changes, you know, the Guts and Glandular can help maintain that and not make it worse and keep that liver functioning properly and add that needed support for the body to then heal itself and rebalance. Yeah. So it's a really nice benefit on that aspect of things.
So it's just a support for the whole body,
basically.
Most
definitely.
Yes.
Yep, every organ. Yep.
And these are?
So this is Ultra Oil and Ultra Joint. They're both put out by the company Ultra Oil. Ultra Oil is a omega-3, omega-6, omega-9 fatty acid supplement.
Okay.
It's a fish-based oil. It's an anchovy, sardine, flaxseed, grapeseed oil. The wonderful thing about their product is it doesn't smell like fish at all.
Oh, okay.
Which is really nice.
Yeah, you have to.
Sometimes you can even smell the fish on the dog when they're drinking fish oil.
Yes, you can.
I have a seafood allergy, so fish makes me go green. So no smell to it whatsoever, which is really nice. The dogs seem to take it really well. For like a 60-pound dog, it's 3 squirts in the food once a day. And your fatty acids are good for your skin and coat. They're good for your joints. It's good for brain health, cardiac function. Again, the list of benefits from fatty acids is amazing, too.
Yes.
So it's a great one. It's also really good for some of these kids when we're trying to do natural support for their allergies. You know, getting a good fatty acid into their diet is helpful. And then recently they put out their Ultra Joint, which is one of my favorite joint products.
Oh,
and again, I often will use the Ultra Joint along with one of the Tea Relief products. Has glucosamine, chondroitin, MSN, collagen, the hyaluronic acid. It also has ginger and boswellia in it to help with inflammation. So it's when you do the natural stuff, again, it takes time to build up.
And it has a very tiny print.
It does have very tiny print.
I was trying to read it. Oh, wait a minute.
It does have tiny print. It is peanut butter flavored as well. So the dogs really, again, take to
that
it very,
that
very well.
Work at my house.
They don't like
my
peanut butter.
No, my boy doesn't like, he doesn't like peanut butter. Why he doesn't like peanut butter is beyond me.
It's one of the joint supplements I've recently found that has all of the good things that they talk about in joints in one formula.
Right.
You know, so it's made to help relieve discomfort, reduce inflammation, and rebuild, you know, cartilage in the joints.
Right.
So it's
a
pretty cool product.
Yeah, very good. Very good.
So they're just some of the products that I have. I have at the Animal Resource Cooperation, we have an area that has all the supplements and some enrichment toys and things like that there.
Very good. Very good. And You've been treating Sadie.
I have been.
You've been working with Sadie.
I have been supporting Sadie. Sadie and I have been working together now for a couple of years, but Sadie was diagnosed with immune-mediated hemolytic anemia, which is an autoimmune.
You want to repeat that?
It's immune-mediated hemolytic anemia, often referred to as IMHA, since it's such a mouthful otherwise.
Yes.
It's a condition that they don't know what causes it, but unfortunately the immune system starts to attack their own red blood cells. It has a high fatality rate, up into the 70s percent fatality rate, usually within weeks.
Wow. It
usually requires treatment with high-dose prednisone. Severe cases can go through transfusions. And even if they go into remission, even those dogs, 20% of them, we lose a couple weeks later. So it's a very sad prognosis. So unfortunately, Sadie was diagnosed at her local vet, and they were given the bad news. And immediately, Kim, again, you know, known Kim for a number of years and helped her mom's dog out. So she reached out immediately to me and said, you know, hey, I'm having her treated by the vet. She's on antibiotics and high dose of steroids. And what can you do? And I said, well, let's work on what I call a plan of action. And so I put a couple different supplements together for her, including the Ultra Oil. Because again, for its immune system benefits, colostrum for its immune system benefits. It also contains a growth factor, so it helps like new cells grow. So we had her on that. We have her on a milk thistle combination because of the high dose pred, which she must have. This is what saved her life.
It's keeping everything in check.
So right with the high dose pred, but we need to protect her liver. So she's on a milk thistle combination as well as a specific liver glandular. And so she's on those, and she's also on the probiotics, digestive enzymes, and the antioxidants, because again, that just supports the whole body in general and just helps the body start to rebalance. And well, Sadie was diagnosed in March of 2021. So she is celebrating her 2-year anniversary next month with her IMHA diagnosis. Her blood work is absolutely gorgeous. She gets routine blood work every anywhere from 3 to 6 weeks. They're currently right now working at her local vet with reducing her pred dose. So she's now currently on a low dose of pred, and they're monitoring her closely. There's been no relapses. The blood work is still beautiful. Her liver values are in check. You know, everything, which we did have a spike in her liver values, you know, during during her initial treatment. But it's all come back down, and she's just, well, she's happy, she's gorgeous, she's beautiful, and she just celebrated her 4th birthday. In December, I think.
Now, what is, how does your vet feel about this?
Her 5th birthday, it was.
Her 5th birthday, go. We all like to be younger, girlfriends.
How does your vet feel about this?
They're all supportive of it. Yes, they're very supportive of it. When I told them that we were going to be working with Pam, they were on board with it, you know. And I told them what she does will not affect what they do. It's just all supportive. So they were very happy with it.
And I do a little write-up, too, if the vet's interested, you know, just like I give the clients with the plan of action. I provide it to the vet, too, if they're interested, so that they have that information and what exactly it is that I'm doing on the other side, you know, of things with her. But especially when you have a diagnosis like IMHA and, you know, they know the prognosis.
And every little bit helps.
So, absolutely. And every her first year, we her first anniversary, we threw a party.
We had cake.
We had cake with a picture of Sadie on.
That's great. That's great.
And during her entire treatment, I mean, her mentality and her attitude, because again, whole body, you know, the whole dog, mental and everything, her mental, her emotional level, everything was good. She pepped up really fast.
Very good.
Yeah. So is it a challenge to continue to give all of these supplements to her?
No.
Do you throw them just in
with her food? Now, her prednisone I have to give to her at night, you know, when she, but her supplements, it all goes on her food. Yeah, so she don't even know she's taking it.
Yes, my hardest, my hardest pet clients are those that are really specific when they don't take food so well, you know. Good thing is Sadie likes her food.
You know, the pred also helps with that. A lot of bigger dogs are way easier than these little tiny dogs.
But when we get to the picky dogs, you know, we work out what we need to try to, again, to figure out what's the minimal we can do for those guys and get the most benefits for their body out
of. Yeah, because if, like I said, with the peanut butter, it's like, well, my God, would walk over and probably try to pick out the kernels underneath. I do feed, you know, a homemade diet, but I'm sure he'd be picking out something out of there, you know. But well, that's great, and she looks good. She really does look good.
Yeah, she's doing amazing.
Yeah, yeah. So what other success stories do you have?
Well, we're also working with Kim's dog, Magnum. I've had a couple different dogs with, you know, what their vet suspects to be degenerative myelopathy, you know, which is where the myelin sheath, which protects the nerve, starts to break down and makes them lose their back end. You're a big dog lady, you know. And I use some different supplements to help with that. Specifically, one of my go-tos and the first thing I start with is lion's mane mushroom, because they've done studies and they believe that it actually helps protect that myelin sheath. And lion's mane is also really good for like a cognitive thing. You know, when the dogs start getting confused as they get older.
And also very good for cancer. So now
Four Leaf Rover has a great product called Seven Shrooms, which is a blend of all of them. And that's a nice go-to when we're dealing with different things too.
So now would this help, like, sometimes you'll see in a dog that their back legs start to shake as they're getting older, and that you would be able to supplement to help that.
That can definitely help improve that, you know, and then doing, you know, some good muscle support as well. So there's a great product out there called Myos, which helps rebuild muscle. It's not one I stock. It's available online though, and it's a wonderful product.
So then you would order products in if you felt that the dog needed them.
Correct. Yes. Or I refer the client to another place. If I don't have the product or I don't have the knowledge to help you, I will refer you elsewhere. I want to be that resource for people so they have somewhere to go.
That's wonderful.
And years ago, it used to be your vet. You know, and you could go there, and they used to do a lot of client education. Anymore, the whole veterinary world is overwhelmed, understaffed, and the timing is not the same. So if people even just have basic questions with the diagnosis they've recently received, I've sat down with them and I've spoke to them and I've worked through them and helped them out with just, you know, understanding what's going
on.
You know?
And with you being a vet tech, that's great.
I have that experience.
That's exactly
right. Client education used to be a major part of our vet tech job. And again, there's just the timing for things.
There's no time for anything anymore.
It's not there.
It's like when you go to the doctor, you know, you got a 15-minute visit and you better get all your questions in.
I
go with my little list, you know, this is the one I want covered here. Quick, answer them.
But I've had some great luck with an osteosarcoma dog who went 2 years past his expectation. And that situation, he was a very, very happy dog to the very end. I've noticed with the supplements, the dogs have a good quality of life. Unfortunately, his tumor actually burst outwards. Which is better than it, you know, going inward. However, that was an ending factor. But he was barely limping on it at that time.
That's amazing.
He did really, really well. Again, some of these anxiety dogs. I work with a little girl by the name of Harper. I know Mama will let me speak about her. Mom wanted Harper to walk in her wedding, but Harper had a huge fear of her leash. When you put her leash on her, she would hit the ground like it weighed 25 pounds. So we brought her into our Zen Play Den, which is at the center in Hamburg, and we started working with her, socializing her, doing a play, like a play and train. They've done studies that dogs learn better when they're having fun.
So
we take this play environment and work in some basic obedience, and so we started doing some confidence building. And she walked in her wedding with her mom. Well, she walked in her mom's wedding in May. She walked Mama down the aisle with her baby brother, who was new to the family.
Very good.
So I was very proud of her for that.
You know,
so some of the physical stuff, some of the emotional stuff, you know, a little bit of combination
Everything's
of everything, you know.
Up in one package.
All one package, you know.
That's exactly right. Well, thank you very much for coming on. It was most informative.
Well, thank you so much for having me. I greatly appreciate it.
Right. And this is Natural Path Pet. In Hamburg. So you can call the Kennel Club if you want more information, and I will definitely put you in touch with Pamela Kneass, and she will help you with your pet. So for this evening, good night.